Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this video, I will show you how to model this truss in sap2000. It is a real project truss. I took a single truss from truss slab, and we will model this in it. We will take the ordinates and create the model. We will enter these ordinates in SAP. We will take this center line and let's begin it. Okay, we will go to file, new model. We'll take grid only. Okay, and next direction we'll take 4 grid lines, and Y we will take only 1, and Z we will take 3. Now we will let the grid spacing as it is, and we will change it later. Okay. Now let's go to XZ plane. Okay. Now we will check the ordinates in SAP. Okay. Let's take first of all this from this point to this point. Is 2 feet and 4.25 inches. So let's go to grid, edit grid data, modify, and we will give the spacing in inches. Okay, it's 2 feet means 24 inches, and 4.25 it is 28.25 inches. Okay, we will go to the next one. We will check it. We will check the spacing. It's from here to here. Let's start here, 2 feet and 4.5 inches. Okay, it's already here. That's 38 feet. Sorry, 38 feet and 6.25 inches. Okay, we will go to SAP, and now we will give it an spacing. We will go to spacing. Okay, we will give it. It's 38 feet, means 38 multiplied by 12, it will become inches. Then 6 and 6.25 inches. We will add 6.25 inch. Okay, it became an inches. And the last spacing is this one. We will copy this and paste it here. Okay, we have done it. Okay, let's go to Z. In Z we have this spacing from here to here, means this is our starting point. So we will check how much the spacing is here. Okay, from here to here, that's 9 and 3 by 8 inches. Okay, we will end it here. We will go to Z, and the first one I will give it in minus because my starting point is like I said from here, so I will give this in minus. Okay, I will give it -9.375. okay, 3 by 8 is 3.375. okay, let's check the second one. It's 5 feet and 6 inches means 65 inches. Okay, 5 feet is 60 inches and 66 inches, sorry. Okay. Okay, we have
done
a little bit. Okay, it was in feet, sorry. I will give it in inches. -9.375 and 66 inches. Okay, this is it. Now we will check the material which is made, from which this truss is made. Okay, we will come here. Only number 1 and 8 are double angles, and the rest are single angle. So we will see number 8. This one is number 8, the main one, and this here is number 1. Okay, the main one. Okay, this double angle 2.5 and 1 by 4 thickness. We will go to shape and define this. First of all, we will define the material. Okay, we will add new material. It's a steel, and it's A36 is good here in the market. It's grade 36. Okay. Now we will define the section, frame section. We will see a new property. We will see if we have this double angle section here. Okay, we will give it the dimensions. The material is A36. Okay, depth, how much is the depth? Okay, it's in feet. We will go to inches. We will select inches. Let's go here, frame section. We will modify this one. Okay, depth, here depth is 2.5 inch. Width, it's 5 inches, and the middle spacing I will keep it as 0.75, so it will be 5.75. okay, thickness is 0.25 and 0.25. the spacing, the back to back distance means spacing, I keep it 0.75. okay, so here is thickness 1 by 4 means 0.25. Okay, let's hit okay. Okay, I will give it the name 2L. What was the name? 2.5 cross. Cross This here was the first material, and we will add the second one, which is single angle. Okay, its name is L 2.5 cross 2.5 cross 1 by 4 inches. So the material is A36. Okay, this will be 2.5, and the thickness is 125.5. Okay, let's come to the first one. You can see that we will go here, draw frame cable, and we will select the double angle. Okay. We'll kick from here to here. Okay. Now I will divide this into two parts. I'll go to edit, edit lines, divide frame. I will number of frame will be divided into two. Okay. Let's go to set display option and hit uncheck invisible. Okay. Now select this point and go to edit, edit point, replicate. We will go to design it. So I want to replicate it here. It's 5 feet and 6 inches. So now we are working in inches, so it is 66 inches. Okay. Okay. Now I will select double angle. It's double angle from here to here. Yeah, right click. Okay. Now I will delete this part. Later on I will see it. Okay. Now you can see here that it's divided into 4 equal spacing, 5 feet. So this frame will be divided into 4 equal pieces. Go to edit, edit line, and then divide frame. We will divide it to 4 pieces. Okay, okay. Now we will come here. Okay. Now we can see that this spacing from here to here is 5 feet and 2.5 inches. So we will come here and we will select this one. We will go to edit, then edit line, divide frame. Okay, here we will come to divide at specified distance from end of the frame. Okay, we will select absolute. Now we can see it was 5 feet and 2.5 inches. 5 feet is equal to 60 inches, and so it is 62.5 inches. Okay, we have divided the first point. We will divide it 2 more times. Edit, divide frame. Okay, then one time again, divide the frame again. Okay, we have done it. Now we will add the single angle section, these sections. Okay, let's do it. Draw frame, and we will draw, we will select single angle. Okay. Okay, we have done it. Right click. Okay, now we will select this whole frame, and now we will mirror it here, so the frame will be completed. Let's go to edit, then replicate, then go to mirror. Go in mirror. We are working in XZ plane, so we are working in XZ plane, so then we will go to parallel to Y. Okay, because if you are working in the in some plane with for example we are working in XY plane, we will go to Z parallel to Z. If we are working in XZ, then we will go to Y. We will go to the third one in which we are not working. Okay, now I will select this point from here to here. Okay, I will give the coordinates. First of all, this coordinate is 0 in Z, and okay, let's check how much is this. This is 259.38 in X. Here we can check the coordinate. Okay, 259.38. We will go to the picket mirror parallel to Y. We will hit 259.38 in the this one, also in this one. We'll copy this and paste it here. Okay. The second point is 66, as we know. Okay, we'll hit okay. Okay, then we can see that we have completed the truss. We will join this point, it will become one. We'll go to edit lines, then join friends. This. Okay, now we can see that we have done modeling. This is single angle section and this is double angle section. We can also extrude this view, so we can check it in 3D. Let's go to set display option and extrude view. Okay, we will see it in 3D. You can check it. This is the truss. Okay, I will do more videos on some complicated trusses and from we will start from easy trusses to some complicated trusses, so please subscribe my channel. Okay, like this we will do this truss in the upcoming videos, then we will go to more complicated trusses. Okay, thank you for watching.